everybody, and welcome to a very spooky video of someone with some creepy mask-covered eyes of one of the characters from the new movie Us. Coming out soon, this movie looks so amazing. If you have not seen the trailer, this movie is not for everybody. Looks very gruesome and scary. So warning, if you are squeamish and scared of masks and creepy things and scarred up faces, telling you now. And one of the characters that really stood out to me in this movie about a family who gets attacked by people that look like them is the character of the boy with the white mask. And in part of the movie, revealed as part of his face, looks like it's scarred up. So I'm gonna do a makeup of him lifting his white mask up and some of the scarring's gonna be shown under his face, just like I saw in the movie previews, produced by the incredible Jordan Peele. So let's get started with the makeup tutorial. So to start off this makeup, I am going to put my hair back in a very low ponytail and I'm clipping it back in the very back of my head. Then I'm gonna put on a bald cap. Yes, we're going challenging a little extra for this makeup video because the mask covers the hair and I really wanna make sure to do it true to the movie. So I'm putting on this bald cap and then I'm getting some Prozade with a disposable makeup sponge and putting it on my skin right before it reaches my hairline, so that I could adhere this bald cap very nicely to my skin, make sure it doesn't have any bubbles. You wanna do this slowly. And do not get any Prozade on your hair whatsoever because you will have to take it out of your hair with your hair. Just that type of prosthetic adhesive. Make sure all the seams are smooth and put a little bit on the back of your neck. Once the bald cap is on and adhered to your skin, we are going to get some liquid latex with the red stipple sponge. The red stipple sponge is perfect because it mimics the texture of natural human skin, but with a very tiny little sponge, which amazes me, and it helps to get rid of the seam of where the bald cap starts and your real skin begins. So we're just covering that seam with the liquid latex, mimicking real skin with this red stipple sponge. All over the seam, you wanna do about 2 layers, wait for each layer to dry. You can use a blow dryer, but don't burn your skin with it. Make sure it's completely dried. Before getting a white eyeliner pencil to outline the eye holes of the creepy mask. The mask in this movie that we're recreating that the child is wearing definitely reminds me of a ski mask. I feel like a lot of very scary movies have white masks in them, like Halloween and Scream, for example, or Saw is a doll that looks like it's wearing a mask. I'm just outlining some of it before getting some white aqua paint. My favorite white aqua paint, especially for bald caps to cover it, is Wolf Brothers or Wolf Effects Hydro Colors in white. It's very, very, very pigmented. And I do about 2 layers with mine, waiting for each layer to completely dry. I'm putting that on my skin, on the outline of the mask part, and all over the bald cap as well. We can't forget that. It's like if Zorro met the huge marshmallow man for Ghostbusters, we would get this mask. You wanna make sure it's completely dry once we have 2 layers of that on. You could also powder it or put some white eyeshadow on before getting some third degree. If you don't have third degree, you could definitely use gelatin. Third degree is a substance from makeup effects shops. You use one part A, one part B of this gelatin-like substance to mix them together, and it activates it and turns it into this substance that is like gelatin, but not as hot. With gelatin, you have to microwave it, so if you use gelatin, make sure that you don't heat it up too hot and put hot gelatin on your face to burn yourself. So this is a lot safer, but it is a lot more expensive than gelatin. But we're mimicking like scar marks on the face, like from the movie. I'm using a cosmetic spatula. Another great product to use for this too is Dermaflage. They have these syringes of like a silicone product they could definitely use too. And they come in various like skin tones and red tones. But we're just using skin tone colors for this, even though it looks white. And once you have that on the bottom of the mask part of your face and some on your neck, we're gonna wait for that to dry while getting some brown cream paint to contour the hollows of my eyes above my eyebrows where we did the circles of the mask. We wanna make sure that we don't paint the white in those circles of the mask because they're gonna be the eye holes. Now I'm just getting some brown matte eyeshadow with a push liner brush and doing the seams of the mask. It has a lot of deep seams in it, like it was homemade. So there's a seam down the middle And I'm getting some black matte eyeshadow to do some shading around the eye parts of the mask, where the mask meets the skin. So this will make it look three-dimensional, give us some shadow around our eyes. Getting that brown matte eyeshadow again to do the other seams that are right above each eye. Again, this looks very much like reminiscent of a ski mask. And then I'm getting some more black eyeshadow with the pencil brush to do some shading on those seams to make it look more and more realistic. You really want to look at reference pictures for this. I just looked up Us the movie and I looked through all the pictures of the masked creepy characters in it. And once you have those seams colored in, I'm going to get some foundation with the foundation brush. And I'm going to paint that on top of all that gelatin or third degree, whatever you used, on the bottom part of your face to make it all look like it's part of your skin. And then I'm gonna powder it down with some setting powder. You can do skin tone or translucent powder. Then I'm getting some matte black eyeshadow to do more seams, but where the mask is folding up around the nose area. And I got some brown eyeshadow to put under that to do more shadow, to make it deeper, more realistic. And using that brown shadow to do some fold marks on my cheekbones, on the cheek parts of this mask, so it's folding up, crinkling above your skin to your eyes, being pushed up to reveal all this scarring. Speaking of scarring, I'm getting some red alcohol paint. If you don't have red alcohol paint, because it's super expensive, it's more of a pro makeup effects artist product. It's activated with 99% alcohol. You could definitely use some red cream paint or lipstick very lightly. I love using Stipple Duo Fiber brushes. I'm using a Duo Fiber pencil brush for this to do a coating of just blood red. But where those gelatin third degree marks that are raised up are, we're not gonna put any blood tones there. So it gives a 3D effect, reminds me of Freddy Krueger or any type of burn victim makeups if you've done them before. Then with the darker blood tone, I'm gonna get in certain parts and cracks and crevices around that skin as well. And then with the matte black eyeshadow and a very tiny detail brush, I'm gonna do the outline around the eyes, because there's not only seams on the forehead and different parts of the forehead parts of this mask, there are some around the eyes too, which will make it more realistic and draw your attention to it even more. Once you think you have enough seams and shadows on your face, I'm gonna get a red coat, just like how they were wearing in the movie. And we are completely done with this makeup of the little child from the movie Us. This little boy seems like he has a doppelganger in the movie that wears this white mask, and I thought I would recreate it for you guys. I cannot wait to see the movie Us. Lupita is in it. Jordan Peele directed it. It's probably gonna be great. I have high expectations for it. Can't wait to see it. Leave me a comment down below on what other makeups you would love to see me do on this channel now that the Hercules series is over. Thank you guys so much for supporting and watching this video. Subscribe to this channel. I do 2 videos a week, Makeup Mondays and Effects Fridays. But now it's time for me to turn back into myself. All the products I use in this video will be listed down below in the description box as always. You have to be really careful when you take off bald caps and any type of prosthetic with liquid latex. I use isopropyl myristate because you want to gently remove it from your skin, or it'll tear some parts of your skin. Not tear off your skin, it'll just damage the first layer. So please be careful. If you guys do this makeup, something similar to it, or any makeups from my YouTube videos, please post on Instagram and hashtag CatSketch. Thank you guys so much again for watching, and I love you. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.